Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Hollowtide here, and this is my fourth time recording this video because everything has messed up over and over and over and over again, and I'm getting really upset, so hopefully this time it works. And if that's not worth a like on this video, I'm trying my hardest to bring you guys up to date on some Halo stuff. You know, just go ahead and leave a like. It really helps me out. But what we are going to cover today is what is seemingly the end of the hiring freeze at Microsoft and 343, as well as the Microsoft CEO talking about console exclusives and how he would love for that to not be a thing. But before we get into that, I just want to say a quick thank you to all the support you all have shown me on my recent videos. It's been absolutely incredible, the amount of new subs that the channel has gained. I greatly appreciate it. We're trying to hit 15K by the end of this year. And if you like somebody, you know, who doesn't cry and complain about Halo, but who also is, you know, pretty critical of it, this is the channel for you. I also uploaded a marathon video and it got like the same amount of views as my Halo stuff. So like, it's been amazing. I won't lie. So just thank you all. But back to the video, Mr. Rebs of Rebs Gaming, who is somebody I follow and I would encourage you to follow them as well. They're, you know, pretty knowledgeable in all of this stuff and seems to really love Halo, tweeted that 343 Industries is looking for a lead game designer to help define future, which is the keyword there, future Halo experiences and build the next generation of games and experiences in the Halo universe. This was the second job that has been posted in the last few days, the other one being an art outsource manager position. So let's just look at some of the responsibilities that the lead game designer will have. We're not going to go over all of them because I don't want to waste your time and some of it's not important. But the responsibilities are collaborate with 343 Studio Design Director and other key stakeholders to define future, there it is again, Halo experiences. Lead the creative expansion and refinement of Halo's narrative, map design, player experience, systems design, character, and sandbox. Lead the creative expansion and refinement of Halo's narrative, map design, player experience, systems design, character, and sandbox gameplay elements with an eye towards delivering deep and immersive games. Set clear design goals and deliverables, focusing the design team on achieving a high-quality, cohesive experience for all players on all platforms. And then obviously the art outsource manager has to deal with art and whatnot and deliverables in regards to that. But one of the things that I think is very interesting is I don't see any mention of Halo Infinite at all in either of these positions. You guys can go double check, but I don't see anything talking about Halo Infinite. It seems like it's all about the future of Halo, future experiences in Halo, future games, novels, comics, all that stuff. So I'm not sure how this will affect Halo Infinite, but maybe this is them starting to gear up for the future Halo games or future campaign expansion or whatever it may be. I don't necessarily think that this means that Halo Infinite is just going to get canceled soon. I think this is a more long-term play. We won't really see what is going to shake out until like that next game comes out. But I think it's exciting to see that they're finally starting to hire people. I feel like, you know, we've been kind of led to believe that there's a skeleton crew at 343 after all the layoffs and whatnot. I don't know if skeleton crew is the right word, but they had massive layoffs and there's been a ton of change in leadership. And this is probably the start of what's going to be the Pierre era of Halo at 343. You know, we've had the Bungie era. We've had the, you know, 343 era with Bonnie Ross and all those other people. And now we're moving into the Pierre era of what Halo is and going to be. So to me, this is a signal that, you know, Halo is not going anywhere. We talk about Halo dying and all that stuff all the time. I just don't think that that's going to happen. People are still, you know, on 343 about, ah, oh, you're finally adding things that were supposed to be in the game 2 years. Like, to me, them adding stuff is showing that they're just not giving up on the game. I really do feel like the people at 343 do care about Halo, and you may disagree with that, and that's fine. Next up, we're going to talk about the Microsoft CEO saying he would love to get rid of Xbox exclusives, but he cannot because of Sony. And if you have not been keeping up to date with all the Microsoft, Xbox, Sony, PlayStation stuff and the FTC trial that's going on, it's been pretty wild. I'm not going to lie, I'm not a console fanboy, you know, console war kind of person, but Sony be dropping the ball in court right now. They're just not very smart. But the Microsoft CEO said, you know, if it was up to me, I'd love to get rid of it. The dominant player is Sony, and they've defined market competition using exclusives, so that's the world we live in. I have no love for that world. But it's basically got people to think, you know, like, what if you could play Halo on PlayStation or Sea of Thieves or Gears of War? all those games on a Sony console, and like obviously that would help Halo out a lot. You give a whole new player base, more people own, you know, PlayStations right now than Xbox, so like you would definitely increase the population of people playing Halo. Now I don't know how many people that would be. Would it be, you know, thousands, tens of thousands of people? I don't know. But I think that it would probably, you know, be in the best interest of Halo at that point to kind of boost a player base like that. But what do I know? I'm not a businessman. But that's going to do it for the video, ladies and gentlemen. I just want to do a quick little update video about the hiring freeze stuff and maybe the end of that and what the CEO said about console exclusives. What I really want to know is your opinion down below. How do you feel about both of these topics? Are you excited about 343 hiring people? Would you be okay with Halo being on PlayStation? In fact, I read all the comments, but I would love to know your opinion on whether or not Halo being on PlayStation is a good idea or not. I'm definitely, you know, I could see it both ways, honestly. But that's going to do it for the video, ladies and gentlemen. If you enjoyed, make sure you leave a like down below. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, and I will catch you around that ring. Peace!